nothing in the program which tells you anything about either Dances of Atonement, which has a kind of interesting history, and also these short fantasies of mine. The first is 1963, and it was written as a classroom demonstration. I was giving a class at Yale in contemporary techniques and suggested to them that they study the symphonies of wind instruments of Stravinsky, which is very Bloch-like in some ways. And so I decided, as rather than make them guinea pigs, I would make myself a guinea pig as well, and wrote a piece. The second piece has another title. It's called Piccola Armonia or something, Fantasia Daveniana, after the name Daveni. Ward Daveni was professor of piano at Yale, and also the father of a beautiful young lady I was courting at the time. So this is a form of dowry. Never thought of it that way, but it comes to me that it was a bribe. The third piece was in answer to a request by the very good contemporary pianist named Robert Miller, who in the 60s was doing a great deal of contemporary music in New York. He was also a notable lawyer. He didn't have enough to do as a lawyer, so he spent the rest of his time doing piano. And so that piece, the third piece, is dedicated to him. And they're separated by, about 8 years of time in the composition. And yet, while they were never intended as a set, I feel that they live well enough together. One of the lessons I had in things living together was living in Rome. When I first went there, I thought this city was chaos. It was a mess. No two styles were harmonious with others. It took me a while to understand that they created a new kind of ambience, a new kind of unity. Leaves of manuscript are from the original. They're all published, but I can't play from published editions. They all seem very strange to me. So short. Would you like to hear another couple of fantasies? I'll play three. They don't take terribly long. And they're all in a collection of fantasies published by Schirmer's. The first is a kind of parody piece called From the Floor. Excuse me, From the Flow. From the Flow. And it's a pun, and it's all based on a very, very dirty joke, and I won't tell it to you. I wrote it in Rome in, I guess, 1991. And it has a kind of circus music, but you'll hear the various references. I never quote things directly, but there are definite references. The second piece is called Addio Roma. I was leaving Rome, and it's very hard to leave Rome. It's a city I love very deeply. And Addio Roma is actually part of a text of the Incoronazione di Poppea, the opera by Monteverdi, where the Regina, the queen, who had been the wife of Nero, is banished, and she's exiled. And she says in a really remarkable aria, Addio Roma. She can't even pronounce it. The last piece, the third piece, is a very short piece dedicated to a great American composer named Donald Martino, a colleague, friend for many years. When he retired from Harvard, a little Festschrift, a little album was made up in his honor, and I wrote this piece. It's actually based on the letters of his name by a very stupid kind of analogy I won't explain to you, but it's one of those demos. If you like the piece, it shows that you can make a piece out of the telephone book if you want to. So, From the Flow, Addio Roma, and the piece is called Three-Fingered Don. That's a curious title. But Don Martino was a great classical composer, a very dedicated serialist, and a serious man, taught at Yale and Harvard and Brandeis. But when he came back from studying with Della Piccola in Italy, he tried to sell his pop tunes on Tin Pan Alley. And since he was a clarinetist and not a pianist, and he wanted to play, he played with three fingers. Just three fingers. So the piece is called Three Fingered Don in his honor. Pieces ferocious.